Yeah, now we are going to see the hardware features about the programmable logic controller. Now this entire RIC is nothing but the programmable logic controller. In brief, it is called as PLC. Okay, now here we have a display screen where you are able to see the command run. That means it is in running mode. Now this is a Ethernet cable. Ethernet cable is connected to the CPU of your system. Ethernet cable, in other words, it is nothing but a communication protocol, a communication module. Because from the system, you are giving input to the PLC and the PLC is going to give you output. So input-output transfer has to happen via a communication parameter or a communication module, which is nothing but this Ethernet cable will be helping. If we don't use this Ethernet cable, definitely we cannot run any program on PLC because it cannot transfer the data. Because this is the medium, so this is very important. So one end is connected to the PLC and one end is connected to your CPU, which you can see down. Now here you are seeing different modules. Now these are called inline modules, Rexroth InMight inline modules. Before we go to inline modules, let's finish this complete box. Now this is brain of the PLC. This square is nothing but the brain of the PLC. What do you mean by brain of the PLC? Now I have given a ladder in my software. I have given a ladder, say for example, to switch on light or to switch on a fan. Now you have given in a ladder, but how do you operate your ladder? This PLC is a remote access machine where you can be able to control the ladder. So now via this inline modules, you can switch on the light and switch off the light with your ladder logic program. Now when I'm controlling the ladder logic program or when I'm operating the ladder logic program, I need the major module in a machine which will operate everything. That is nothing but this Profibus EEPROM, or you can also call it as a brain of the PLC, where whatever program you are giving in your software, how you want to operate with these switches, entire operations are being carried out in this square box. So without this, you can't actuate any operation. So everything will run inside this. Suppose how we run every thought in our brain, we think so many things deeply, you know. So that's how this works. Now, this is an Ethernet I have already covered. Now this is a screen. Why do we need a screen? Now you need a mobile screen, right, to see what exactly or to type a message. You have a screen. Screen is very important. To diagnose the PLC, to know the health condition of the PLC, to know whether it is running or not, you need to have a small display screen. Without the screen, you cannot know whether your logic is right, or maybe you are working in a logic, you are trying to run the PLC, but something is not going on well. So the screen display it's nothing like a shortcut, you know. It will give you the whatever. Suppose it has been stopped, it will give the command stop. So that the screen is very important. Now here on the screen, below the screen, you can see escape, down arrow, up arrow and enter. Now I'm going to show this. Now I've entered. This is my Ethernet. Now you can see 192.168.1.25. That is the IP address of the PLC. Not IP address of the system. What do you mean by IP address of the PLC? Now here we were discussing, we need input and output transfer of data. Definitely, I want to switch on my light and switch off my light using PLC with a ladder program. So PLC has to switch on the light in my room with sensors. So now, if you want to switch on the light with the PLC switch, some input has to be given. That means you are giving input to the PLC in form of a ladder program. Okay, now your PLC will give you output. Whenever you are pressing that particular switch, it will switch on or switch off. These are the switches where you can see. Now, to do that, you need a communication protocol. Fine, we have learnt it just before. But when I need to transfer my input and output, we need, as how we need this communication module, definitely you need IP address. Now, suppose you are sending some, or you are ordering some food from Swiggy or Zomato. So definitely you have to order from a restaurant to your home. So you need from address and to address. Like that, your input is your restaurant, your system, your ladder program. And what is your output? Where is your home? What is your home address? Is nothing but the IP address of the PLC. Now, from where PLC, suppose imagine I am your PLC machine. Okay, I want to receive the input from you that please switch on the light using some switches. Please switch off the light using some switches. So you are giving me input and definitely I have an address. So definitely I'll give some output. Based on the address only, your input output will function. First, suppose you made a mistake. Now your IP of your computer is matching with IP address of your PLC. Now what happens? Suppose in Swiggy app, I have given the restaurant address as from and to address as the restaurant only. Now, will your food be delivered to you in your home? No, it is gonna be there only. You won't get the food. That's why here also you need to have input as different, output as different. It's very simple. There's no logic behind it. It's very simple. You know, so here your IP of your system is different from your IP address of your PLC. So now these changes were done before. You need not, you know, bother about how you change the IP address of your PLC. As this is an online session, you need not bother of the step. Suppose you're coming to the center and doing it, that time you need to learn. Now, as of now, let's continue our session. Now this is my IP. Okay, sorry. Now keep it in run mode. Keep it by default in run mode. Now here you can see stop. Suppose you're using your mobile for some long time and background some applications are running. So what happens to your mobile sometimes, you know, your battery gets heated up and you get some pop-up on your mobile screen that, you know, your mobile has been heated up or, you know, camera won't work. You need to switch off the PLC for 5 to 10 seconds. Again, you restart. You won't be able to see any red light near the stop. Then it will be refreshed. You can run your codes after you restart the PLC. So that is one way. And next, after you reset your PLC, there's one more thing called reset S1. Now, this we should use in emergency situations. Emergency is nothing, it's not always related to your. So reset we use in emergency situations. That means you are running your PLC, it is still in run mode. This emergency situation is no way concerned with your safety or something. This will not harm anyone, the machine. So until we harm the machine. So now this is run. Now you are running the ladder, you're doing some ladder in your computer. So when you're trying to run the program and operate the program with these switches, still you won't get the output in your computer or on your project which you interfaced with PLC. So everything is fine, but you're not getting the output. Now what is the reason behind it? Now here you're not seeing any stop, or nor you're not seeing in here also. So what will be the reason? That means totally the machine has hung up. So you need to reset it to the zeroth mode. Now what will you do? You can take this pen. I'm not doing it right now because it's not required to do. You can't do this 100 times, 1000 times, because this is a very rare, very rarely you'll face this situation, because this works for a long time, not an issue. So this nib is there. You can press it. I'm not doing it now. I'm just showing you the trick. You need to press it for 10 seconds and leave it. It will be reset to the 0th mode. So that is the last. Now here down you come, you see some RS-232. Here it is written RS-232. You know, even if it is not written also, you know this one is RS-232. Now here we have a Ethernet, ETH. There we have a RS-232. Now what is this? What are these both mean? Both are nothing but communication parameters, communication modules. Now, what is this communication modules? I have already told you initially, when you are giving the input, you have to get the output from PLC. Definitely you need something to communicate. Now I need to take a class. You need to understand what is PLC. So in what way can I communicate? Through speaking in English language. English is known to everyone. Okay. So that way you will learn about PLC. Now when input and output has to be transferred, when you have to run your project here with interfacing to this machine, definitely input and output have to be transferred through this Ethernet cable, through this communication medium. Like that, we also have one more port called as RS-232, which we are not using it. We are using it only this. This is an optional. You can either go for that, either go for this. Now, I will show you. You should not remove the flashcard when the PLC is on. You have to switch off and remove it. This is, you should not remove it. Just for your understanding purpose, I am removing it and showing you guys. Now this is your flashcard. What do you mean by a flashcard? You have a hard disk in your computer, so where everything is stored in memory of hard disk, like that, whatever ladders you will be doing is stored in this flashcard. Okay. Now you can insert it back. Yes. Okay, that is your flashcard memory. Now coming to our exact inline modules. Now as I told you, this is Profibus or brain of the PLC. These are inline modules. This is on board. This gray color entire rectangular board is nothing but on board. Now here you have a power cable, power supply, 24 volts DC power supply. Now what are these red and blue color circles? These are my switches. You want to do a project interfacing with the PLC. Fine. Or okay, leave about a project. I have given a simple ladder. I ask you to control that ladder with the PLC. Now using these one of the switches, you can control what is going on your computer screen. Same thing, you can interface a project. With any one of the switches, you can control your ladder program. Even if you do a project, interface the wiring with these input and output modules, you have to control with these switches.